This is Papa Bell, and welcome to Transport Fever. What are we doing here? This is a map I call Centerpopolis. It's not my map. It's a map with Texas City Grid map. So if you'd like to download it, it's a flat map with 25 cities on it in a grid formation. From the Steam Workshop. And right now we're just looking at some time-lapse video footage of me reconstituting the roads in the city here. Just basically making the city have less issues with traffic. And this is how I chose to do it. I wanted to put some extra large roads in, so in order to do that, you really end up tearing down your whole city. So what am I doing here? I am systematically demolishing all road transportation in the city. Earlier footage showed all the trams and buses going back to the station that I used to disperse them. There they go right there. Here we go. Demolish. Got about 60 billion in the bank, so this city is good to go. It's been a real progression. I started out with stations right there in the center. The six bank stations, six platform stations going out from the center here. These ones, to the far left. And then the two platform stations came towards the end, but bumped out once from the middle to about the middle going outwards, the middle ring, you could say, and then once to the outer ring. So I moved the stations three times to let growth occur. And we're gonna totally obliterate the city except for a few buildings in the center, because I went through a playthrough. I obliterated every building and there was no growth whatsoever. So don't obliterate all your buildings if you're gonna do it. You leave at least one building. You'll see it's really close to just being one building. This is my first time-lapse footage, so if it's not very good, I apologize. I'm experimenting with overlay and title screens and, you know, everything good that goes with a standard good video editor. I believe this is at 425% speed. Yeah, I'm a Detroit Lions fan, so you know life ain't easy. But, you know, it's easy to decide whether you're going to be a fan or not. We're just waiting to go buck wild, man. We've been waiting a while. And for each station, I decided to, you know, make the road connections a little larger so I could put the big roads in there. And, you know, in order to do all this stuff, you really got to start from scratch. You'll see what I mean in just a minute. how those roads that were there weren't gonna cut it. See, and if I upgraded that road, which wouldn't have upgraded because it wasn't there, it would have blown up all the buildings anyway. Yeah, I've had a cold for a couple days. Took me a good hour and 20 minutes to destroy the city and rebuild the road structure. You can see, even as I'm tearing it down, it's trying to build back up. Traffic's pretty good. It's not 80%, it's not outstanding, but line usage is, say, around 50% when I start letting it run again. I mean, I will pause it at some point. Let's pause now. So that was, I paused in mid-growth. Just trying to figure out where those buildings were coming from. So yeah, this is really good. I mean, time lapse allows me to put that hour and 20-minute video into about 20 minutes, which is good. There is a slight issue, though, and the issue is that I cannot see the footage in the editor at the moment. I can only see the voiceover capture. So I don't know exactly when my video ends. I believe the video ends at around 20 minutes and 12 seconds, something like that. And since I've started over, I tried to make them as straight as possible. As you can see, there are going to be a few that I just didn't want to spend any more time on, but are really close. So you're going to give it to me. That's what's going to happen. You're just going to let it go. You're going to let it fly. If I can give it to myself, you can definitely give it to me. That's just how we're going to play. Let's see here. I knew right away that I was gonna have to do something tricky once that happened. You gotta blow up something to make something else right. Boom. There you go. All those roads are pretty freaking straight. And that's good. Even though it's not too tremendously important that they be straight. Actually, in my opinion, a little bit of curved action gives, streets some character. Oh, excuse me, especially from the above perspective. What's cool about this is eventually, and maybe somebody else will see this. It kind of ends up looking like a spider's web. That, when it grows, of course, it's going to put in its own roads as well. There was a point when it looked like my computer was gonna poop out, so I saved it. And that's all right. I mean, I got a new laptop that I can use with, the RAM and all that. But I think the Lions are doing well. I should check that out. Oh yeah, there's little bits of the road, the old road, just scattered all over the place. And that also prevented me from upgrading the roads. It'd be like construction not possible error message. There's a kind of a middle ring, and then we're gonna do the outer ring now, which is bumped out even farther. Probably not gonna get any growth if it grows from the center on that outer ring, but I'm not worried about it. It's for transportation purposes only, as far as I'm concerned. Now when I hit the play button, I think I do it after I build a tram line and put some trams on it. You'll see how fast this thing wants to grow. I mean, it's gonna grow. It's gonna start growing pretty fast. Then it's gonna slow down. Our trains are still going back and forth. We pushed play there to get rid of the station, the old station markers. 'Cause we're gonna make all new stations. We're going to check out various stations and their placement. We're going to end up going with the big tram station. Yeah, this one right here. We're going to try. It's not going to be a direct straight road connection to the road because the road is curved. We're trying to make it plumb with Stations Road in the side. As you can see. So there's our outer line. We're just making avenues with the extra large road. And it'll be functional once we get the tram lines in there. See, it kind of looks like a spider's web. See, we're gonna be heavy on the trams by the stations. Train stations, we're gonna be heavy on the tram stations because we're gonna have tons and tons of people coming in to begin with. Like every single city, there's 24 cities hooked to this city right now. Once we draw in the line, you'll see how that font is functional. It's very cool once the line is actually connected. Austin City trams. Boom. Not even gonna do a counterclockwise, cause we may put the the other way in afterwards. But right now we're just doing the one way. And there's this area on the right side of my screen that doesn't allow me to select. It's like the mouse pointer goes into a different program. Exactly what happens. I don't know where it is, I don't know what it is, but it prevents me from, using the mouse in this game. It's just right there in the right middle. But as soon as I move it, we're all good. Call it the toilet bowl. Sorry for the spinnaker right there. We're gonna make them green. Yeah. All right. Boom. Look at all that growth in the first freaking month, man. Just one click away and it's like halfway filled up already. The middle's all good. Like I said, I'm not sure exactly when this video ends, but when the footage stops running, I will stop recording and we'll see what we got. I'll look back on it. I think it's pretty good though. Just trying to get out the video. Voiceover is just as important. Could have some cool music going, but I'd rather just kind of explain what this is. We're going to put in some more trams. Reconnect all the roads and